Okay, then yeah, this is joint work with Carsten Lutz, Adrian Puccini, and Frank Wolter. And yeah, let's start. So this is the ontology mediated querying session, but in some sense we are interested in the inverse problem. So we have given a knowledge base, let's say in this example about conferences, and we have some positive answers, positive examples, which are the answers that we expect, in this case Tempe and Rome. And we have some negative examples, which are somehow the answers that we don't want. So Hildesheim and Liverpool in this case. And the question is whether there is a query that separates the positive from the negative examples. Well, and in this case, yeah, there is one, namely give me all the cities that have hosted a KR conference. This kind of reverse engineering questions have many applications in AKR, for example, in concept learning, in description logics, then in query by example, both in databases and also in ontology mediated querying, and also generating referring expressions and entity comparison can be cast as such a reverse engineering problem. And yeah, as usual, we make this open world assumption, so a knowledge base in this talk is an ontology plus a database. Yeah? Okay, so let me formally define the problem, the separability problem. So we have a knowledge base, we have positive examples and negative examples as input. And the question is whether there's this logical separator between P and N. Well, in this case, because the ontology is present and because of the open world assumption, there are actually two versions of this separability problem, the weak one and the strong one. In both versions, we require that the separating query is entailed at all the positive examples, but they differ in the treatment of the negative examples. So for the weak separability, we require that the separating query is not entailed at all the negative examples, while in the strong case, we require that the negation of the separating query is entailed at all the negative examples. So we didn't come up with these two notions. They have been around in the literature and have been studied. Yeah. There's another dimension, sort of. So there's projective and non-projective separability. And the question here is whether this separating formula can use helper symbols, that means symbols that are not present in the knowledge base. And to illustrate that this can actually make a difference. So if in this small example, A is a positive example and B is a negative example, then they cannot be separated or distinguished by an ALC concept because A and B are bisimilar. But if we allow this extra symbol, let's say P, then they are separable by this concept. So A and B are projectively weak separable. Okay, in this paper, what do we do is we study the separability problem, but we add another input, namely a signature restriction on this separating formula. So we have this sigma as an additional input, and we ask whether there's a sigma formula that separates the positive and the negative examples. And the motivation is that in practice, well, the user might have some intended signature about of the separating query. For example, you might want to forbid or exclude information about race or gender. Yeah? And so you want to have a more specific separating query. Main interest in that we have in the paper is the computational complexity of this problem. And we study projective weak separability with the signature restrictions and strong separability with signature restrictions. And in the strong case, it doesn't matter whether we allow additional symbols or not. So I will drop projective and non-projective here. What I find interesting is that this additional input leads really to a change of the nature of the problem. So what we have observed before is that projective weak separability without signature restrictions somehow corresponds to rooted QCQ answering, and the strong separability corresponds to knowledge-based satisfiability. Now, if we add this signature restriction, then the nature of the problems change. So we get the correspondence to conservative extensions and interpolant existence. I will tell you in a second what these are. But I find this quite amazing. So yeah, and now of course there's another kind of dimension. We can look at different ontology languages and also at different languages for the separating formula. And in this work, we look at description logics, ALC, ALCI, and ALCO, and also at some decidable first order fragment, such as the guarded fragment and the two variable fragment. Okay, so let me start talking about this projective weak separability, and I announced a relation to conservative extensions. So let me also recall the definition. So if we have an ontology O and extend it with some new ontology O prime, then the result is a conservative extension if, well, every concept that doesn't use any fresh symbols and is satisfiable with respect to the old ontology is also satisfiable with respect to the extended one. Now, this is a classical notion. It has been studied for the description logics, for many description logics, and also for the guarded fragment. And for the description logics, ALC, ALCI, and ALCO, we give a reduction of deciding conservative extensions to the complement of weak separability. And the idea is that the proof is not so difficult. And the idea is that the separating formula plays the role of the witness for non-conservativity. Now, in ALC and ALCI, conservative extensions are known to be 2x time complete. So we get this as a lower bound for weak separability. For ALCO, the complexity actually was open, and we show in the paper a triple exponential lower bound for conservative extension. And we also show matching upper bounds via reduction to the emptiness problem of two-way alternating tree automata. Now, this as a corollary, we get also that projective conservative extension in ALCO are 3x time complete, which I find also interesting on its own. Now, for the guarded fragment, it's also known that, well, it's known that conservative extensions are undecidable, but we cannot go via this reduction to weak separability. So we have, what we did is we adapted the known undecidability proof for conservative extensions. And we get undecidability. Okay, so let me now talk about strong separability. And I said that there's a connection to interpolation. So let me also recall interpolation and interpolance. So if we have given two formulas, phi and psi, then a formula theta is an interpolant. If it's in between phi and psi, so it's entailed by phi and it entails psi, and it uses only the symbols that are common in phi and psi. And then there's this very famous property, the Gregg interpolation property, which says that an interpolant for phi and psi exists if and only if phi entails psi. Well, one direction of this if and only if is always satisfied, namely if an interpolant exists, then phi entails psi. This is clear. The other direction is not always satisfied, but many logics do also satisfy the other direction, and then it is said that they have the Gregg interpolation property. For example, first order logic has the Gregg interpolation property. So now, what does this have to do with strong separability? And for this, we make first two observations, let's say, or insights. And the first one is that if we have given a knowledge base and a signature and some example A, let's say, then we can write the first order formula that describes the knowledge about A that we have in term. Somehow it describes the sigma portion of the knowledge that we have about A. Yeah, we can write the first order formula phi k sigma A. And using this, we can now make the connection to separability. So let's consider an instance of the separability problem, so a knowledge base, positive example A and a negative example B and a signature, then a formula is a strongly separating formula between A and B if and only if it's an interpolant for phi k sigma A and the negation of phi k sigma B. So this is not a difficult thing to prove. I mean, it essentially uses the definitions. And but it says that, okay, the strong separability coincides somehow with the existence of interpolations. Now, if we are interested in separating formulas formulated in first-order logic, then because first-order logic satisfies the Kreck interpolation property, separating formulas exist if and only if this entailment is true. And from a practical point of view, well, we can compute these separating formulas using tools that compute interpolants in first order logic. Yeah, and now, well, this looks a little bit dangerous. Yeah, we have to check entailment between first order formulas, but actually, because these first order formulas come from like knowledge bases in restricted languages, we can actually decide this entailment via a validity check in a knowledge base language. So we get all the complexities are the same as validity in a knowledge base language. Now, if we are interested in separating formulas, not in first order logic, but in the knowledge base language, then the insights that I have shown you provide a reduction of separability, strong separability, to the problem of deciding whether there is an interpolant. And well, if we start in a knowledge base in one of these description logics, then we reduce to interpolant existence in ALCOI. And if we start in these decidable first order fragments, then we stay in these languages. Now, these languages don't have the Kreck interpolation property, but it is known, well, since very recently, it's known that we can decide interpolant existence. And well, in ALCOI, this is 2x time complete, and in the guarded fragments, 3x time complete, and two variable fragment, it's between 2x time and co non-deterministic 2x time. And yeah, so in this way, we get the upper bounds from these known results on interpolant existence, and the lower bounds we get via straightforward modifications. So let me conclude. So we have studied the impact of signature restrictions on the separability problem, and we have established very interesting connections to conservative extensions and Kreck interpolants. And this is an overview of our results. So the gray columns are our results, and the white columns are the known results of the on separability. And yeah, we have also some future works. So we want to look at the computation problems. So that means, how can we actually compute these separating formulas, and how big can they be? We want to evaluate this this computation of strongly separating formulas via these first order tools. And what is also left open is the question, how difficult are non-projective conservative extensions in ALCO? Okay, that's it from my side. Thanks, and I'm open for questions now.